is that. And now he's talking to you today. He's talking to you. Pray you teach him today's lesson. Praying for him for the soul of our heart. May I not talk about the reading for today? Well, that's the Barnabas. And then the Lord Jesus himself, so let's share some of it with you. So, I told my dad a lot to say, Lord God. We reviewed it together, teaching us that these words are truly divine. In the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Did you ever say, well, I didn't once. It was strange. I fell asleep in my bed. And early in the morning, I woke up in the church, on the couch. But when I opened my eyes, I didn't know where I was. It was dark. So it wasn't my bedroom. It was very confusing here. As my eyes adjusted to the light, I realized where I was. It was funny that I was in the living room, but I was safe. I was home. St. Paul, who was a companion of St. Barnabas, said, "For now we see in a dim mirror, but then face to face, now I know in part, then I shall love fully, even as I have been fully known." What I want to leave you with today is hope, trust, faith, understanding that the world around us can be dark and scary, but God is always with us, that we are always safe at home. St. Barnabas told us, he knew that Jesus is God, that he was crucified and died, that he rose again and ascended into heaven, that he promised to come again to judge the living and the dead, and that he was indeed that he would spend eternity in his presence. St. Barnabas understood that Christ's eternal presence is both wonderful and terrible at the same time. But that time, C.S. Lewis promised to come again. St. Barnabas knew that all people come into Christ's presence. And he wanted everyone to experience the wonder of God's love and grace in heaven. We know something about St. Barnabas in the Bible. He was a companion of St. Paul, missionary to the Gentiles. He was St. Paul, one of the few people in the Bible called apostles, even though they were not among the original 12 apostles. He was the only apostle brave enough to trust that Paul converted from being a persecutor of Christians to a Christian itself. There are other stories about them that are not in the Bible, but many people believe them to be true. It is believed that he and St. Paul were students together under the Gamaliel, a member of the Jewish synagogue. This would explain why he trusted Paul. We are told that his name is actually Joseph, and the disciple of Jesus called him Barnabas, because of his personality. Barnabas means son of encouragement, or son of consolation. Maybe most important are the stories about his earliest birth and last birth as the son of Christ. St. Barnabas is believed to be one of the 70 apostles sent by Jesus in Luke chapter 10. Bring the good news to the surrounding communities. We see in the Bible that these apostles were among the people who witnessed Christ's miracles, but the ones who read this morning, they saw with their own eyes that Jesus had power over creation, power to heal diseases, power to pass that demons, and even power to raise the dead. Seeing all these things firsthand, they were sent to share the good news with the world. Apostle means sent them. Just like St. Barnabas saw the darkness of the world, he knew that the UPC did. But because he saw the power of Christ, because he knew that Jesus is God, he had hope. He knew that everything would be okay for those who heard him, trust him, and put their lives in his loving arms. This was so important to St. Barnabas that he would eventually fill for his resistance to sharing the gospel. St. Barnabas' last path was to be martyred. I want to share an example of my favorite superheroes in Spider-Man. My favorite movie in is the end of Spider-Man No Way Home. Semi-spoiler, early in the movie, the fear of her act is selfish. But at the end of the movie, you realize the only way to save everyone is to give up everything you love. Maybe a fate worse than that. No one would know who he was. He would be entirely alone in the world. Why did he do this? Love. He saw the darkness of the world and knew that he could fix it. Out of love, he didn't have meaning. Quiero compartirles que Dios tiene un ejército sin palabras. But this example can be inspired. Now, every Spartan says, Spartan is called, with great power comes great responsibility. St. Barnabas lived into that. He saw the life of Christ and shared it with everyone. But my friends are St. Barnabas.
Going live on our regular systems. Thank you for holding with us.